So now that we've looked at a few examples of types of problems that arise when biology becomes easier and cheaper and more distributed, we're going to look at some of the strategies in the past that people have used to try and control biology's use in international settings. So one particular example of trying to guide the development of science and technology is using national and international law and agreements. So in this case, the foremost example is the Bioweapons Convention, formed through an international treaty across different nations that essentially say they will not develop biological weapons, or they won't develop biological capacities that allow offensive use. One challenge about these types of agreements is the enforcement. We don't have an enforcement capacity within the Bioweapons Convention to ensure that nations aren't are essentially adhering to the agreements within that treaty. Another example of strategies is actually the scientific community coming together to develop standards of practice. One prominent example of this is around Asilomar, when a group of the founding molecular biologists in the 1970s imposed a moratorium when they found out they were able to cut and paste DNA very easily. They got together to develop standards around how they could safely use that technology. Those standards were then given over to scientific communities that were able to develop them into formalized guidelines and rules. These have now been extended, and they're not only the review of safety, how scientists themselves are able to safely use their technology, but also into security. This has brought up a lot of questions as to whether or not scientific communities are in fact able to evaluate whether or not their experiments have not only safety concerns, but also security concerns. One of the other strategies for countering biological threats has been simply to develop detection and response capacities. So if there is an event, how are we able to respond to that? And this is, again, an accidental event or also an intentional event. If we see that an emergent biological disease is occurring before we know whether or not it's coming from an intentional or an accidental or an emergent threat, how do we develop vaccine production or therapeutics especially quickly? Another precedent in strategies is actually, again, to look at the limiting distribution of biological knowledge and information, as well as limiting the distribution of people who might have specific knowledge, and limiting distribution of the materials. And these fall under many different regimes, but they also include things like export controls.